Okay, today we'll start with new chapter. One is equation, and this equation we have used in our different classes, in our preschool classes, class 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have solved many equations, okay? And we must know about the middle term factor, and middle term factor you must know from class 6, 7, 8, 9, okay? So we'll try to solve these types of equation now and try to understand what is actually quadratic equation and what is cubic equation and different types of equation. That means what will be the types of equation we'll try to understand now. So now I am going to the chapter equation one. So solving quadratic equations, that means how to solve quadratic equations. That means you must know these types of equation, y equals to x square plus bx plus c. You must know x square plus bx plus c. This is the actually quadratic equation name. This name what? Quadratic equation. And how to solve quadratic equation? Now we will try to practice it. You must know here the coefficient of x square a, coefficient of x is b, and c is the constant term. Okay, so a, if a is greater than 0, then this, the curve of this equation will be like this. Okay, and if a is less than 0, that means a is less than 0, then the curve will be like this. So this is look like a parabola. Okay, and this is this name what actually equation? Quadratic equation. Remember it. This name what? Quadratic equation. First of all, how to derive the quadratic equation? This is the quadratic equation. Now, x square plus bx plus c equals to 0. These types of equation is called quadratic equation. Remember it. These types of equation is called quadratic equation. X square plus bx plus c. We can solve this equation, and this is the solution of this equation. X equals to minus b plus minus square root over b square minus 4ac divided by 2 a. And this name is called what? Quadratic equation. So the definition will be what? What is quadratic equation? The equation which is consist of one variable. The equation which consists of one variable is called quadratic equation. And this is the second degree equation, because highest power of variable what? 2. Highest power of variable 2. So this is the second degree equation. So second degree equation means what? Highest variable will be, highest power of the variable what will be? 2. Highest power of the variable will be 2. And this is the second degree equation. So the second degree equation of one variable is called quadratic equation. Second degree equation of one variable is called quadratic equation. Remember it. And this is the solve for you. So this is the actually quadratic equation which we are solving now. Standard quadratic equation. Standard form of quadratic equation. X square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Now x square, dividing by a on both sides, dividing by a on both sides, we get this line. Then a and a cancel. This is why only x square, and b by a into x, okay, plus c divided by a equals to 0. Now we can write this line, x square b by a into x equals to what? C by a, what will be? Minus c by a on the right hand side, okay? So from this line, we can write this line. Just making a plus b whole square formula. How we can write this? A square plus twice ab plus b square. Okay. Just b by 2a. We are taking b by 2a on both sides. Okay. B by 2a on both sides. To make a formula, a plus b whole square like this. Okay. A square. If you make this formula, a square plus twice ab plus b square, then you get immediately this line. Okay. So this equals to minus c by a plus b by 2a whole square. So this whole what? X plus b by 2a whole square. And this equals to minus c by a. So b square by this 2a whole square means what? 4a square. Okay. 4a square. So x plus b by 2a whole square equals to what will be minus c by a into 4a, just multiplying 4a, okay, to make b square by 4a square here. Now from this line, we can write this line, same line, okay? This line and this line same. Just we are x plus b by 2a whole square equals to minus c minus 4ac divided by 4a square. Here also 4a square. Now taking LCM 4a square, we get this line. Taking a square root on both sides, we get this line. Okay, you can write this one also. You can use this one. You can also solve this one also. You can use this also. That means multiplying by 4a on both sides. Multiplying by 4a on both sides. You can use this concept also. Suppose we want to solve this equation. The roots of a quadratic equation x square plus bx plus c equals to 0. This is the quadratic equation because highest power is 2. And this is the second degree equation. And second degree equation of one variable is called quadratic equation. Remember it. And its solution is this. That means x equals to what will be minus b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac divided by 2ac. Remember this. A equals to coefficient of x square. A equals to what? Coefficient of x square. And b is the coefficient of x. Coefficient means what? Which is multiplied with the variable is called coefficient. And c is the constant term. Remember it. So if we want to solve this quadratic equation x square plus bx plus c equals to 0, that means if we want to find out the value of x from these types of equation, so how we can get? So we will derive now the general formula for finding the roots of quadratic equation. Roots of quadratic equation means what? Solution of the quadratic equation. Remember it. So multiplying 4a on both sides of this equation, we get what? 4a square x square plus 4abx plus 4ac equals to 0. So 4a square x square plus 4abx equals to minus 4ac. Just adding b square on both sides, we get this one. And we get a formula. What? A plus b whole square formula. A means what? Twice ax. And b means what? Only b. So if we take this formula, we get this one immediately. So this equals to what? B square minus 4ac. Now taking a square root on both sides. Taking a square root on both sides. So we get twice ax plus b equals to plus minus square root b square minus 4ac. Remember it. If we take a square root on both sides, you must put plus minus. Because minus 2 whole square equals to 2 whole square equals to 4. So if we take the square root of 4, but it will be plus minus 2. Because minus 2 whole square equal to 4, plus 2 whole square equals to 4. So the square root of 4 will be what? Plus minus 2. In this is why we have to put plus minus here. So twice x equals to what? B will be what? Minus b here on right hand side. So x equals to just dividing by 2a on both sides. So we get this formula. And this is the formula. We have to remember this formula. This is the formula for finding roots of the equation of quadratic equation. Remember it. This is the formula for finding roots of quadratic equation. So how to solve equation in this way? We will apply middle term factor first of all. Then if we fail to solve by using middle term factor, then we will use the quadratic equation formula. Remember it. So we have a machine to solve equation. Which is the machine we have derived earlier? Which one? X equals to minus b plus minus 4ac divided by 2ac. This is the machine for solving equation. Now we'll try to solve equations. That means we'll now try to understand how to solve equations now. So solving quadratic equation by a square root property. We can solve these types of equations. Solve x square equals to 49. How we can solve this equation? You must know. X equals to what? just taking square root on both sides. Okay, plus minus root 49. That means what? Plus minus 7. Just 2x square equals to what? 4. Just dividing by 2 on both sides, we get what? X square equals to 2. So x equals to what? Plus minus root over 2. And this is the actually square process. How to solve these types of equation? Y minus 3 whole square equal to 4. Y minus 3 equals to plus minus root over 4. That means plus minus 2. So we get y 3 will be added. Okay. 3 minus 3 will become plus 3 on right hand side. So we get y equals to 3 plus minus 2. So 1 is 3 plus 2. 3 plus 2 means what? 5. 1 is another is what? 3 minus 2. So 3 minus 2 means what? 1. So this is the actually square method. Now solving quadratic equation by completing a square. This is another method. How to solve quadratic equations? Completing a square. Completing, suppose y square plus 6y minus 8. How to solve this types of equation? Just completing square, taking 9 on both sides, we get a formula for this y plus 3 whole square formula. Okay, y plus 3 whole square formula equals to actually y plus 3 equals to plus minus 1. That means only 1. So y equals to only, we get minus 3 plus 1, and another is minus 3 minus 1. There will be plus minus 1. Remember it. There is a mistake, printing mistake. There will be plus minus 1. So solving, completing a square, we get. Now quadratic equation formula. Actually, we are talking about this. Another technique for solving quadratic equation is to use the quadratic formula. And this is the quadratic equation, x square plus bx plus c equals to 0. And has the solution what? X equals to minus b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac divided by 2ac. We have derived this equation. And this is very important formula for finding roots of the quadratic equation. Remember it. Solve for it. Now, how to solve these types of equation? That means x square minus 6x plus 8 equals to 0. This is the actually quadratic equation or second degree equation, because highest power is 2. Our highest power of variable what? 2. This is why it is called second degree equation. And second degree equation of first one variable is called quadratic equation. Remember it. So now solution will be what we have. This is the actually given equation. Okay. Now we can factorize this one. 4 into 2 equals to what? 8. That means 4 into 2 equals to 8. That means to get 6, we can write this line x square minus 4x plus 4x minus twice x plus 8 equals to 0. Right. In this case, we get. X square minus 4x, we can take x common like this, x into x minus 4. Now another minus twice x plus 8. From minus twice x plus 8, we can take common minus 2. Okay, then we get minus 2 x minus 4 equals to 0. Again x minus 4 is common here. Again x minus 4 is common, so we get x minus 4 into x minus 2. If we take x minus 4 common here, we get immediately x minus 2. So we get x minus 4 into x minus 2 equals to what? 0. Equals to 0. So either x minus 4 equals to 0 or x minus 2 equals to 0. Therefore, x equals to 4 and x equals to 2. So this is the roots of the equation. Remember it. Roots means what? Solution of the equation. Same word. Same words. Roots of the equation means solution of the equation. Roots of the equation means what? Solution of. Okay, now how to solve these types of equation? X square minus 6x plus 8 equals to 0. Okay. Now, this we have to use or here. Or then we can write x square from 8 we can write what? Minus 4 4 into 2. Okay, from 8 we get 4 into 2. So to make 6, we can write 4 plus 2. Okay, so we can write 4x minus twice x to get minus 6x. Okay, now we'll try to solve the quadratic equation by middle term factor method. Okay, now how to solve x square minus 6x plus 8 equals to 0. So we get by middle term factor, that means from 8 we can find 4 into 2. Okay, 4 into 2 equals to 8. So we can write this minus 6x like this, minus 4x minus 2x plus 8 equals to 0. Now we can take common x into x minus 4 and minus 2 common from other two part. Minus 2 common will be what? X minus 4 equals to 0. Or x minus 4, again x minus 4 common, x minus 4 common. Then after taking x minus 4 common, we get another x minus 2. Okay, so x minus 4 into x minus 2 equals to 0. In this part, we can write either x minus 4 equals to 0 or x minus 2 equals to 0. Okay, so from this part x equals to 4 and from other part x equals to 2. Therefore, hence the required solution is x equals to 4 and 2, and you have solved in our in your preschool. So middle term factor method is very easy method for you, and you have solved these types of solution previous. How to solve the quadratic equation by another middle term factor when the coefficient of x square not 1. Okay, when the coefficient of x square greater than 1, then we can solve it another way. That means we have to multiply the coefficient of x square with the constant term, then we can make the term for middle term. So middle term process, using the middle term process, we can find out this one. So using the same process, this is the example one we have solved. This is the example one, and we will try to solve another one by using the same procedure. Same procedure. Okay, now example two. Example two will be what? Coefficient what? Coefficient was what? Coefficient?
3.
Then 14. Plus 14. Plus 14. Plus 14. Sorry, minus 14. Minus 14x plus 8 equals to 0. First of all, we have to multiply 3 into 8. Okay, 3 into 8. That means 3, 8 what? Multiply 24.
24.
Okay. 24. Then we can make 14 how?
12 plus 2. 12 minus 12.
Minus 12x.
Minus 2.
Twice x. Plus 8 equals to?
0.
No. This will be. No. This is the wrong way. We are.
Coefficient 3x square.
3x square minus 14x plus 8. So to get this one, we have to take another one.
Sir,
right, you are right. So this will be 3x square, right?
Yes,
3x square minus 12x minus 2x plus 8. Now taking thrice x common, how we can get thrice x common? then we get x minus what? 4. Then
minus 4.
Then what will be? Minus 2 common x minus 4. So we get x minus 4 and thrice x. Minus x minus 2 equals to 0. So either x minus 4 equals to 0.
0 or thrice x.
Thrice x minus,
minus 2, 2 equal equals to 0.
That means x equals to 4 or x equals to what will be?
2.
So this will be thrice x equals to 2. So we get from this. Therefore, x equals to what will be? X equals to, from this line, 2 by 3, right?
Yes, sir.
2 by 3. 2 by 3. Hence, the solution will be what? Solution 4 comma. What will be? 2 by?
4 divided by 3.
2 by 3.
2 by 3.
So this is the required solution for this case. If the coefficient of x square exists, then we can solve in this way. Remember it. Okay? For this equation, if there are a coefficient of x square exists, then you have to solve in this way. This is another process for middle term factor. Remember it. Now, how to solve the equation? How to solve the equation by using quadratic formula? That means this is the quadratic equation x square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Now, using this formula, we have derived these roots of the equation. There are two roots. One is positive roots, and another is negative roots. So there are two roots. That means two values of x from this quadratic equation. Now, using this this one, we can solve. Suppose we have the equation 11n square minus 9n. Equals to 1 by the quadratic formula, we can write this is the quadratic equation, like 11n square minus 9n minus 1 equals to 0. So we can write here comparing with this, a equals to what? 11. Okay, comparing with this, variable is what? N. Okay, just comparing with this one, a equals to what? 11, and b equals to what? Minus 9. B equals to what? Minus 9. C equals to what? Constant term minus 1. Okay, so a, b, c, what? Just putting in this formula, we can write this line. Understand everybody?
No, sir. Will you explain this again?
Okay, now I am solving this equation by using another method. That means using the quadratic formula. So how to solve? Solving quadratic equation by using formula. Can you tell me the question? What was the question?
2x square minus 10x square.
Okay, 2x square. 2x square.
Minus 10x square.
Minus 10.
X square.
Minus 10x plus. What?
10x square.
Minus 10x.
10x square. X square. 10x square.
10x to the sir.
Minus 10x.
5.
Plus
5.
Equals to 0.
Plus
0. Now, how to solve these types of equation by using this one? Now. By comparing pairing the given equation with the quadratic equation. Actually, quadratic equation means you must know quadratic equation with quadratic equation. That means x square plus bx plus c equals to 0. This is the quadratic equation. So by comparing the given equation with x square plus bx plus c equals to 0, we get a equals to what? A equals to, here a equals to, a means this a, okay, coefficient of x square, comparing with the coefficient of x square, here a equals to, here a what? 2. Okay, here a equals to 2, and b equals to what? Here b, coefficient of x what? B, and coefficient of x what? Minus 10. Okay, b equals to what will be? Minus 10. And c equals to what?
5.
So using the formula, we know the formula NOW, no, x equals to what? Formula what? Do you know? X equals to minus b, then plus minus square root b square minus 4ac divided by 2ac. You must know this formula. We have derived this in our earlier of this lecture. Okay, x equals to what was? Minus b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Just using this formula, we can solve this equation. Now, how we get this one? Or we have to use or, remember it. Or x equals to minus b means what? B means what? B minus 10. Okay, minus 10. And another one is plus minus, then square root b square means what? Minus 10, right? Minus 10 whole square, then minus 4ac, okay? Minus 4, a means what? A means 2. Then c means what? 5. Okay, divided by 2ac. 2 into a means what? 2. Just putting these values, we get this one. So this equals to can be written as what? Minus 10, then plus minus square root over minus 10 whole square means what? 100. Then minus what will be? 40. Okay, and this will be
4.
Only 4. So after this line, we can write, and this equals to what will be? Minus 10 plus minus root over 60, right? Root over
60
divided by 4. And this equals to, actually, this equals to, we get root over 60 can be written as what? 4 into 15, right? 4 into
15.
And so minus 10 plus minus root over 4 into 15. 4 into 15. into 15 divided by 4. So this can be written as minus 10, and 4 into 15 can be written as what? 2 into root plus minus 2, 2 into root over 15, right?
Root over 15
divided by
4.
Divided by 4. So after this line, we can write 2 common from the above. This equals to just taking 2 common here. 2 will be common. Then we can use first bracket minus 5 plus minus root over 15. Very easy for you. Root over 15 divided by 4. So this equals to 2 and 2 will be cut from numerator and denominator. So minus 5 plus minus 15. Root over 15
divided by 2.
15 divided by 2. Divided by 2. Actually, there are two roots of the equation. Hence, the solution, the required solution is x equals to this one. Okay, x equals to this one. That means one is plus, and another is what will be? Another will be minus. That means there are two roots of the equation. Okay, so one is positive for plus, and another is negative for minus. So we get how to solve quadratic equation by using formula of quadratic equation. This is the quadratic equation, remember it, and we know this formula, and we have derived it in earlier of this lecture. So just comparing with this, A equals to what? 2, B equals to minus 10, and C equals to 5. Just putting ABC here, we get the roots of the equation. Very easy for you. Now, another example, 3x square minus 14x plus 8 equals to 0. So say in the similar process of previous example, by comparing with the given equation with x square plus bx plus c equals to 0, this quadratic equation. So comparing the coefficient of variable, that means x square coefficient what? A. Here x square coefficient what? 3. So a equals to 3. Another is x coefficient what? B. So x coefficient minus 14. So b equals to minus 14 and c equals to 8. So using this formula, we have derived in earlier of this class. So using this formula and putting these all values of ABC, we get this one, x equals to this. Okay. Just we get two roots of the equation. That means the required solution is x equals to 4, 2 by 3. By using this formula, you can solve any quadratic equation. Suppose A, B, C, any real numbers. You can make thousands equations. So just how to solve this? We have already solved by using two methods. One is middle term factor method. Another method is by using quadratic formula.